Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about section 10.3, verifying trigonometric identities. And to start us off, we need to take a look at page 628 in our book for this great list of all the formulas we'll need to know. Okay? Now there are a lot here, and you're going to need to have a lot of them memorized. I'll tell you which ones specifically in class. So the first three identities are called the reciprocal identities. Identity is just a word for a true equation. So in other words, these are just formulas you need to know. Cosecant is the reciprocal of sine. We already knew that because sine is y over r and cosecant is r over y. So they're reciprocals of each other. Secant is the reciprocal of cosine and cotangent is the reciprocal of tangent. We also know that tangent can be written as sine over cosine. If sine is y over r and cosine is x over r, we can simplify y over r over x over r. And when we do so, we end up with y over x, which is what tangent is. Cotangent is the reciprocal of tangent. So if tangent is sine over cosine, then cotangent is cosine over sine. Okay, so here are our first five formulas. We need to have those memorized. The next three are really important. You'll need to have these memorized as well. Sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. And then these other two, 1 plus tangent squared equals secant squared, and 1 plus cotangent squared equals cosecant squared. Okay, let's talk about these three for a second, and then we'll come back to these last six. We know that if we draw an angle on the unit circle, it has a radius of 1, and we know that the x value is equal to cosine of theta, and the y value is equal to sine of, sine of theta. So this point xy here shows us cosine of theta and sine of theta. Using the Pythagorean formula, we can state, because this is a right triangle, that x squared plus y squared equals 1, right? But because we know x is cosine and y is sine, we can also write this as cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta equals 1. When we have our squared there, it's like as if we're writing this, cosine of theta quantity squared plus sine of theta quantity squared. This is just the notation that we would normally use. So here's our first Pythagorean identity. In your book, it's written as sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. And I'll switch to using x instead of theta, but we can use any variable we want. If you're having trouble memorizing the other two, you can get them by dividing this equation by either sine squared or cosine squared. I'll show you sine squared. If we divide everything by sine squared x, we end up with sine squared over sine squared, which is 1, plus cosine squared over sine squared. Now, if I look back at the formulas from the book, where do I see cosine over sine? I see it right here, which is equal to tangent, or sorry, cotangent. So if cosine over sine equals cotangent, then cosine squared over sine squared equals cotangent squared. And of course, we know that the reciprocal of sine is cosecant, and so 1 over sine squared is cosecant squared x. So by dividing sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1, by dividing everything by sine squared, we get 1 plus cotangent squared equals cosecant squared, which we see right here. 1 plus cotangent squared equals cosecant squared. If instead you want to get this one, you have to divide sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1 by cosine squared instead of sine squared. Okay? So that's a little trick. If you can memorize this one, you can find the other two pretty easily. The last six, I'll go ahead and tell you now, the last six functions or identities I'm going to give you on the test. So you'll be able to reference them. Sine of pi over 2 minus theta equals cosine theta. Cosine of pi over 2 minus theta equals sine theta. And tangent of pi over 2 minus theta equals cotangent theta. These are the cofunction identities. And then lastly, we have our negative angle identities. Sine of negative theta is equal to negative sine of theta. Cosine of negative theta equals cosine. And tangent of negative theta equals negative tangent of theta. Okay? So what can we do with all of this information? Well, the first kind of problem we're going to do is one that we could have done before using a different method. So here's our first example. We're given that cosine of theta is negative 12 thirteenths, and we're told that theta is between pi and 3 pi over 2, and we're asked to find the other five trig functions of theta. Okay? So the way we would have done this before is we would have said, theta is between pi and 3 pi over 2, which means it's in the third quadrant. Here's pi, 180 degrees, 3 pi over 2 is 270. It's some angle here, isn't it? Because I'm told that cosine is negative 12 thirteenths, I know that's x, negative 12, over r, 13, which means the length of this side of the triangle is 12, which of course allows this coordinate to have an x value of negative 12. Using the Pythagorean formula, 12 squared plus what squared equals 13 squared, I can find that the length of this side of the triangle is 5. And so the coordinate here is negative 12, negative 5. And I've got my x, y, and r. Using x, y, and r, I can find sine theta, which is y over r. I can find tangent theta, which is y over x, which simplifies to 5 twelfths. And I can find cosecant, secant, and cotangent by taking the reciprocal of sine, cosine, and tangent. So the reciprocal on negative 5 thirteenths is negative 13 fifths. The reciprocal of negative 12 thirteenths is negative 13 twelfths. And the reciprocal of 5 twelfths is 12 fifths. Notice that tangent and its reciprocal are positive, and that makes sense because all students take calculus. In this quadrant, only tangent and its reciprocal should be positive. Everything else should be negative. So cool. So that method we could have done before, but now we're going to actually use our Pythagorean identity to do the same thing. And this is what I'm going to want you to do on your problems as well. We know that sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. And we're told in this problem that cosine of theta is negative 12 thirteenths. So I can substitute negative 12 thirteenths into cosine of theta here. I end up with sine squared theta plus negative 12 thirteenths squared equals 1. Okay, when I square a negative number, it becomes positive. 12 squared is 144. 13 squared is 169 equals 1. Let's see, I'll need a common denominator so I can subtract 144 169ths over. So I'll rewrite this as 169 169ths. Subtracting 144 169ths, I get sine squared theta equals 25 169ths. And then I need to take the square root of both sides. And when I introduce a square root where there wasn't one before, what do I need to introduce along with it? A plus or minus. The square root of 25 is 5, the square root of 169 is 13. And so I get sine theta is either positive 5 thirteenths or negative 5 thirteenths. Because I'm also told in the problem that theta is between pi and 3 pi over 2, I know that theta is in the third quadrant. All students take calculus. And so only tangent and its reciprocal should be positive. That tells me sine should be negative, and I know to go with the negative 5 thirteenths. So I've got sine now. I was given cosine originally. To find tangent, I would take advantage of the identity that says that tangent of x, or tangent of theta, is equal to sine of theta over cosine of theta. So sine is negative 5 thirteenths. Cosine is negative 12 thirteenths. When I'm dividing a fraction, I do, let's see, the negatives cancel. I do the numerator times the reciprocal of the denominator, and I get 5 twelfths. So I know sine, cosine, and tangent. To find cosecant, secant, and cotangent, I would just take their reciprocals, like I did up here, and I would have my answers. Okay, so it's another method of doing the same thing that we used to do. We're going to practice this method for the problems for this section. All right, there's a second video on section 10.3, so be sure and watch that as well.